There's a myth, okay, about coax lengths. I've just done a search on the internet, right, for CB radio coax length. And it's this whole myth about this company recommending 18 feet and so on. I'll tell you where the myth comes from and why, on the surface, this sounds actually quite good. It's completely wrong. Okay, so I've done a couple of videos about kind of CB radio, actually on the basis of encouraging people to move over to ham radio, because if they really like CB radio, they'll love ham radio. That's the only thing. You can hate me or love me, I don't care. It's not going to affect me, all right? It's affecting you, this. I can't drink your poison, only you can. Okay, so in the last video we did, we talked about attic antennas, and we determined that the length, the wavelength, is literally about 11 meters. In other words, if you put a sine wave on 27 megahertz and measured the distance from there to there, it really is 11 meters. Now then, if you, so that distance there, 27-ish megahertz, right? And I think that's 27.272727 recurring is exactly 11 meters, all right? So that is 27.27, which is exactly 11 meters, or about 36 feet. Now, this from here to here, that distance, if your antenna was at this point on the right-hand side, any old antenna, we'll just draw a little antenna, you know, whatever, bit of coax going back to your radio. As an amateur radio operator, okay, and an antenna manufacturer, I happen to know that every half wavelength, so that says 11 meters, and on the we recommend 18 feet. 11 meters is about 36 feet in old money, right? If you're in the USA, half of 36 is 18, okay? Divide by 2 is 18 feet. And that's why they're recommending 18 feet of coax, even if you don't need that much. Now, part of this myth is sort of true. In other words, a really good bit of fake news, there's an element of truth in it somewhere along the line. Do you know what I mean? So I need to just explain one thing to you. If you've got an antenna designed for CB radio, a commercial antenna, you'll find that it will have something called a 50 ohm match there. Your CB radio itself is expecting a 50 ohm match. Doesn't matter what that means, right? Bananas, doesn't matter, okay? And the coax itself, the bit of coax between the antenna and the radio, will also be 50 ohms, right? It just so happens that every half wavelength, which is this bit there, right? Every half wavelength, the impedance here repeats. Here, it just repeats. Okay, so if this is not 50 ohms, if this is 75 ohms, and you measured it at the half wavelength point, you'd find you would also have 75 ohms there as well, every half, which means every double, you'd also get the same here. Now, because I've got a CB antenna, and you've got a CB radio, and you've got the right coax, it doesn't bloomin' matter how long, effectively, this coax is. It doesn't matter where you feed into it or cut into it, you'll always have 50 ohms. Where the myth is, and I don't know, you went into transmission line theory here, okay? So we'll draw our little aerial here, okay? We'll put our radio back here again, and we'll put our different colour, we'll put our coax along there, and we determined that if, let's say, you have 100 ohm antenna, for whatever reason, right there, and you have our 50 ohm CB radio, you know, 40 channel, whatever it is, and our 50 ohm coax, we will find, if you divide one by the other, there's an SWR of 2, it's called 2 to 1, SWR, standing wave ratio. We're trying to get that low-ish, maybe under 2 would be handy, right? But we're not on 100, okay? We'll be on 50, all right? And it's not exactly half a wavelength. So let's draw our sine wave, our 11 meters, all right? It just so happens that although 18 feet sounds right, RG58 cable and RG213, and other cables, have something called a velocity factor. And I think both of these, don't quote me, it doesn't really matter, but certainly one of them is 66%, which means that the speed of light inside this coaxial cable is actually 66%. So this half wave, this 18 feet, isn't 18 feet anymore. In fact, if we just quickly fire up the calculator, 18 feet times 0.66, it's actually 11.88, or nearly 12 feet. All right, so is it 18 feet or is it 12 feet? Well, as we determined earlier on, it doesn't blooming matter. You've got a 50 ohm system. So what I would say is you just keep this as short as you can, all right? So what coax do I really want for my CB antenna? Well, if it's a mobile radio, you're not going to have much. You just keep cut it, put a plug on the end, and that's it. Doesn't matter, okay? And if it does matter, then the only time it actually matters, the length, is if it's a big home base install, you know, and you've got an antenna actually on the roof. Now, there's, you will find coax loss charts. You will find you can work out yourself. We can work this out. RG58 at 50 megahertz. Well, 10 megahertz, it says here, is 1.4, and at 50 megahertz is 3.3. So it's going to be somewhere between the two. And it gets worse as it goes up. So I would say for 100 feet or 30 meters, we're looking for RG58, we're looking probably 2 dB. 3 dB is half your power. So if you've got a 12-watt radio with 3 dB loss, then what you'll find is your 12 watts becomes 6, effectively. Same on receive, right? You'll be duller on receive as well. So in fact, how long should my coax be? You buy the best coax you can and get the least amount of loss. You've got 50 ohms here. You've got 50 ohms here. Your transmission line is 50 ohm. You will just see 1-to-1 SWR. And I'm going to give you a little tip on SWR. An SWR curve on CB radio will look a bit like this. So let's put an x-axis in. There's x-axis that way. We'll have y there. Okay, let's have 3-to-1 here. So that's 1-to-1, 2-to-1, 3-to-1. Yeah, okay, fine. We'll do it like that. There's 2-to-1 SWR. You've got 40-channel radio. You will find that channel 1 will be about here and channel 40 will be about here. And you will see, you know, if you look at the SWR meter, you'll see, oh, well, that's fine, you know, a little bit high at the edges. You've got to remember, and I said it in the last video, the only thing CB operators need to worry about is SWR. So they worry about it, okay? What I can say is if you're under 2-to-1, the chances are you won't be losing even more than 1 dB. All right, you'll never notice it. If you gave me two antennas, one with 1 dB loss and one with no dB losses, I couldn't tell you which one it is, right? You would never know. So, but knowing roughly what that is, and that's 40 channels from there to there, if you put your SWR meter on and you've only got a 40-channel radio and you see something like this, because that's all you can see, you can see about 1.5 here and about 2 or 2.5 to 1 there. We know that your antenna must be, and this is frequency, so channel 1, channel 40. What we can say is that the ham radio 10 meter band is starting 28 megahertz, roughly there. We know this antenna must be too short. We'll need to make it a wee bit longer to bring it lower, to bring it down there. So you don't need an analyzer. A simple set SWR meter can tell roughly where you are on the curve, because you can just plot it out. Oh, channel 1, channel 10, 20, 30, and 40. On channel 1, oh, I'm about, you'd be able to work it out. Oh, I'm about 1.5 there. Channel 10, you know, 1.6. Channel 20, 1.8. You know, I'm at 2-to-1 there, and I'm at or 2.5 there, and you can see, you'll be able to see literally this curve, and you think, oh right, so if I just come down about the equivalent of 40 channels, that's all I need to do. By the way, there's a really easy way to do that. You just do this, look, watch. M0, MCX, that's my amateur radio call sign. SWR, it's probably remembered it. SWR calculator. You'll be able to do this, right? You can download it here. Well, I've downloaded it twice by accident. And you know that the frequency, this frequency here, put it in red, this frequency here is, let's say, 27.555, and you're aiming for 27, let's say 0.2. It says here you need to add, on a quarter wave, add 3.3 centimetres. 3.3 centimetres. 2.5 centimetres is about 1 inch. That's about just over an inch, for instance, would bring this bit of the curve down to that bit of the curve. Anyway, the best thing you can do is buy the right coax in the first place. And these people who go on and on endlessly about coax lengths, how to store the coax, put it in a figure of eight, and all this sort of stuff. Baloney, honestly. This is shielded coax. Okay, there is. Frankly, if I had a bit of extra shielded coax, I'd put it in a coil like this, because that will act as something called a dirty ballon, keep some RF off the outside of the line. So, and the problem is with CB radio, there's a ton of myth out there, and nobody very often knows what the hell they're on about. Hopefully, this has given you a bit of inspiration. Hopefully, you'll understand now why it doesn't matter. You keep the length as short as you can, keep the losses down, and enjoy your radio. That's it. Nick's video is coming up here, and underneath it, I'll put a bit of a binge watch playlist, have a flick through. Might be some things there that will spark your interest, what we do around here. All right, Callum, my end. All the best. Have a great day. Bye for now.